Chapman, good ball. McAllister unmarked. Teal in hard. McGrath's header, and McClellan, I think, caught Cyril Regis round the neck then, and he's complaining to the referee. Regis wasn't spotted by any of the officials. Garrigo. Curious layoff by Chapman. It's gone straight to Dalian Atkinson. Now Regis. Kubicki. Brought down by Wallace. Villa's free kick.
I don't think either side has been helped by the standard of the pitch. There was a big bubble there for Lee Chapman, which was resulting in that curious ball that you talked about, Alan. But apparently Villa are so upset about the pitch, they're going to sue the people who laid it a couple of years ago, Little Bird tells us.
Here's York. Atkinson in the middle, but he never really had a hope of finding him. No meat behind the cross. Staunton. Daly. Good ball. Blake. And White controls it now for Leeds. Staunton lunges in on Strachan, and the referee's given a free kick to Leeds. Quickly taken, and a bit too quick perhaps for Mel Sterland. That's an interesting byproduct, if you like, of the new look at Leeds today, that Mel Sterland, freed of the responsibility of marking Tony Daly, has been given the opportunity to get forward as often as he can, and that'll be something he likes. He's always enjoyed attacking in his career.
He's more or less playing as a right side midfield player today.
Richardson's clearance to Kubicki. McGrath. An excellent run by Richardson into space. And the cross was well met by White. Villa's corner. Signals his intention. McGrath got the header in, and despite the fact that Regis and Atkinson looked very close to being in an offside position, I don't think the linesman flagged, so that
I think he did give offside.
He did in the end, did he?
Judging by where he's putting the ball as well, Lukic. Yes, it was very tight actually, because I think Strachan was caught running out there, but there's so many of them in there, but it was inevitable he's going to give it.
Offside was indeed the verdict. Touched on by McAllister, taken by Wallace, and now Chapman. Kubicki in quickly, and always a heart in the mouth time for a fullback making a tackle in the penalty area like that, but it was a good clean challenge. Corner turned on as well, dangerously into the goal mouth. York gets it away. Really good header on that was by Chapman on the near post. Here's McClellan. Wallace, Kubicki right behind him. It's only a throw. Leeds were hoping for a free kick. Patty hurls it in towards Chapman, but it was cleared by Teal. McClellan getting it forward again, and the whistle has gone, presumably for offside. Seely, never one who's shy to express his wishes to fellow defenders, I think you could say. Certainly one of the reasons that he's keeping Spink out at the moment. He's a very noisy sort of goalkeeper who helps defenders a lot. And he's got Villa moving forward with York. And came off White, who defended well. And Batty just calms things down. And the long ball to Chapman. Wallace just guessed the wrong way. Teal helping it on first time. And Fairclough cleaning things up for Leeds. White. Leeds fans enjoyed that. Wallace just got himself into an offside position. He's made a quicker than expected return after a groin operation, Rod Wallace. Leeds club record signing, £1.6 million, along with his brother Ray from Southampton in the summer. Clearance by White, York onto it. This is Blake. Got that all wrong, really, young Mark Blake. 21 next month, preferred in the side at the moment to Gordon Cowans, who's a substitute today. Dorigo. It's lovely skill. Batty gives it in back. To find Wallace. White to Sterling. Played it in behind Fairclough, who really had no option other than hitting it back to Lukic then.
I don't think we've had a chance yet, have we, Alan? I think both sides look very tight, but neither side at the moment look like breaking down the opposition, but that can quickly change here.
And it could with Wallace. Good save by Seeley. Richardson gets it away. Excellent goalkeeping by Les Seeley. Because Rod Wallace looked odds on to score then. Dorigo finding Batty. Sterling. He does love to shoot from a long range. And again, Seeley had to be equal to it. There he is again. Mr. Angry, as Ron Atkinson called him. Furious at his defenders for allowing not one, but two openings to happen here for Leeds.
Great chance there, he's decided on power, but Les Seeley stood up very well and made a good save, but I think I worked that one out there. I thought if I said nothing had happened, then it all would.
And you were right. Almost midway through the first half then, still no goals, but now things beginning to open up perhaps. And it's Leeds in the driving seat at the moment with Strachan. McAllister. Dorigo. Back to the Scot. And now Strachan, the captain. That's a lovely reverse ball from McAllister. Excellent tackle by Kubicki. What a deft little ball that was from Strachan.
Started to get on top now, Leeds. Had a great chance with Wallace there. The thing about if you go through on a one-on-one with a goalkeeper and you do decide to blast it, you are relying on luck a little bit. Because you generally aim at the goalkeeper with power.
Strachan's corner towards White, and it could have sneaked through. And Chapman with a header. And another marvellous save, really, by Seeley. Well, no wonder Ron Atkinson's got faith in this goalkeeper at the moment, the way he's playing. This is a great reaction save. It wasn't a powerful header, of course, by Chapman, but from that range, he could well have scored. Richardson to Kubicki. Batty intercepts. Kubicki does the same thing. And in the end, Villa get a throw. Regis. Richardson. It's a good looking ball. Free kick has been given to Leeds, who were rather unhappy about that. They felt that the referee had played advantage, it would have done a bigger turn for them then, really. Good opening here, though.
Yes, another good chance. Again, I think, as he's turned there, he's gone for power. And again, it's gone straight at the goalkeeper. The point I'm trying to make is if you place the ball in the corners, at least you know where it's going. When you just blast it, you are relying on that good fortune.
Defending by McGrath meantime at the other end, and a bloodied nose for the Republic of Ireland international, who said to the referee, "I'm all right, take a lot more than that." A couple of broken limbs, I think, to get poor McGrath off the field. Ron Atkinson calls him quite simply the best centre-half in the world.
Yeah, he's a tremendous player. He's been instrumental in all Jack Charlton's success with Ireland, whether he played at the back or in midfield. Great player.
Disappointing end to what had looked a promising attack then for Villa. But Paul McGrath, I know that Brian Robson rates him as the best player he's ever played with, and that's quite a tribute from the former England man.
I'd say it's no fun playing against him.
I'll bet. In fact, this is not a fun ground for you, you were telling me. Villa Park, incredibly, you've never scored a goal here.
I've not only never scored here, Alan, I've never won here. And that includes games when I was a kid with Leicester in the youth team and all sorts of things. It's probably why you usually get a nice reception at Villa Park.
Well, we're waiting for the first goal in this game, but it's certainly livening up now. Leeds have another free kick.
I'm just glad I never signed for them.
White has gone forward, McClellan will take the kick. Chapman flicking it on, came off his shoulder, and Seeley followed it all the way. Kubicki, Richardson, Blake, Kubicki again. Having a word with Tony DiRigo about that. Mistimed rather than vicious, but a foul nonetheless. McGrath hitting it in towards Daly and Atkinson. McClellan gets it away. Richardson back in again. It's offside though. Dwight York. I noticed incidentally that Villa have switched Dwight York and Tony Daly around here, Gary, to presumably try and shake off Chris Fairclough's attention, but he's followed him all the way over to the other side of the field now. Word on that in a moment as McGrath gets it clear. McClellan turned on by McAllister. McGrath with the clearance again. Now here is Fairclough getting it ahead of Daly. And DiRigo gets it out.
That's right, it's just to see if they'd switch fullbacks at all. He's trying to shake him off, but Fairclough has gone with him onto this side. It's not going to make a tremendous amount of difference. It'd be interesting to see if they put him down the middle and play all three of them up there. If they can get the centre-halves in each other's way, they might find a bit more space down the flanks.
Good ball, DiRigo to Chapman, and then Blake takes it off him. This could be an interesting break. We've got plenty forward here. Staunton in possession. In it goes early, and Lukic had read the danger. Equally, there's a lot of room for DiRigo to attack. Forward to Wallace, he's offside.
The game's really opened up now. I mean, the last 10 minutes has been some great football and lots of chances. I think it was just that initial period of a bit tentative. But both sides are really going at each other now. Far more entertaining.
Staunton heading it forward. McClellan has won everything above the ground so far. Strachan finding Chapman. Back again to the captain, and a good ball to DiRigo. Came off McGrath, off by Batty, and again the flag raised for offside. I think it was Wallace again who strayed too far forward, almost too quick for his own good at times.
I think actually it was Lee Chapman that time. As the ball was headed on, he was just a little bit slow coming out.
There's Seeley, who's made a couple of outstanding saves already for Villa. Good kick by him, but White underneath it. This is Chapman. McGrath's challenge. Daly trying to get in and succeeding in getting in ahead of the defender, but not ahead of Lukic. Good goalkeeping.